Hello everyone, I am Dr. Millie and you are watching Erudite Chemistry. In last video, we have learned how to calculate oxidation state of various metals. Now in this video, we are going to understand first what are redox reactions and then we will see types of redox reactions. Okay, so let's start with what are redox reactions. The very first thing is the redox reaction are those in which oxidation and reduction takes place simultaneously. So wherever you see that there is a change in the oxidation state of element from the reactant to the product, that reaction is known as oxidation reduction reaction. And definitely you will see both kind of changes. It will never happen ki only oxidation is there but reduction is not taking place in the particular reaction, or only reduction is there, oxidation is not taking place in that reaction. Actually both the reaction, oxidation and reduction, takes place simultaneously together. That is why this name redox is given to you. Let's see how it is happening and let's see how we are going to recognize them. So first of all, I'm writing down one reaction here. It was a very simple reaction. It is Na plus Cl2. It is the elemental state of chlorine and it is forming NaCl. So if this type of reaction I'm having, so what is the oxidation state of sodium? As we know, it is an elemental state, oxidation state will be zero. As this is also at its elemental state, its oxidation state will be zero. This we have learned in the last video. Those who have not done how to calculate the oxidation state, please go through the video in which I have explained to you oxidation number, then come to this video. So here we can see that sodium is at the plus 1 oxidation state and minus 1 oxidation state is chlorine. So now we can see here that sodium is turned into NaCl, but we are just going to concentrate on the sodium only, ki what is happening with the sodium. So here I am writing down only the ion which is made up by the sodium. So this is sodium plus, because NaCl mein sodium is at the sodium plus state. Now the next one is chlorine. So let's see what is happening with the chlorine. Chlorine, which was molecule before at the oxidation state 0, is now Cl minus in this molecule. So this is Cl minus. So what is happening here? This sodium, which was at the 0 oxidation state, means there was no loss, no gain. Now this has at the loss of one electron. It means this might have lost one electron. This is loss of electron, and loss of electron is called oxidation. So here this is oxidation. So always remember that loss of electron is oxidation. Okay, on the other hand side, this chlorine, which was at the zero oxidation state, means there was no loss, no gain on it. But now it is having one electron on it. It means what? It might have gained the electron so that it turned into the minus state. So in this case, because two chlorine atoms are there, I will take it as two chlorine atom here also, and I will give it two electron this side, because it is the gaining react. They are reacting together to form this chloride minus. So this is called gain of electron, and gain of electron is named as reduction. Okay, now write it here. I'm writing it here. Gain of electron is called reduction. Now this way we can see here both type of reactions are taking place. That is, reduction is also happening and oxidation is also happening. And it is very obvious that both the reaction will take place simultaneously, because if this sodium will not lose the electron, how this chlorine will gain? So that is why both the reaction will always take place simultaneously. And this is the reason that the name redox is given to these type of reaction. So I hope it is clear that you have to understand first what is going on with the reactant and how they are turning into product, either by losing electron or by gaining electron. Then we have to see which one has lost the electron and which one has gained electron. And then we can decide which is getting oxidized. So I can write down on the arrow, this is oxidation and this is reduction. Okay, so this way we can identify the oxidation and reduction reaction. If you want to make it very simple for you, you don't want to consider the loss of electron or the gain of electron, the one trick is that increase in oxidation number. Increase in
oxidation number or oxidation state means 0 to plus 1. Here in this case, it is changing from 0 to plus 1. So this is an increase, that the number is increasing from 0 to plus 1. So always remember, whenever you see the increase in oxidation number, you will consider that change as a oxidation. And this increase in oxidation number can be 0 to plus or minus 2 plus or plus 1 to plus 3 or plus 2 3 2 plus 3 or plus 2 2 plus 4, any kind of changes. Matlab plus mein smaller value se bigger value ki taraf, ya fir minus 2 plus ya fir 0 to plus. In all the cases there is increase in oxidation state or increasing oxidation number, and in all the cases we will be considering them as oxidation reaction. But if there is a decrease in oxidation number, that is decrease in oxidation number. Decrease in oxidation number is regarded as reduction. So what type of reaction they are? Reduction. For an example, in this case, chlorine is changing from 0 to minus 1. So this is decrease in the oxidation state. It was 0 before, now it is minus 1. This means reduction of chlorine is taking place because its oxidation number is changing from 0 to minus 1. So this is reduction. Or in the cases when we are getting plus 1 to minus 1, or we are getting minus 1 to minus 2, or minus 2 to minus 4. If the value is decreasing, the value of the number is decreasing, it means that it's a reduction reaction. I hope it is clear that oxidation and reduction will take place simultaneously. Oxidation is increase in oxidation number, reduction is decrease in oxidation number. Uske alawa, if you want to go for the deep, means what is actually going on, you can see there loss of electron is called oxidation and gain of electron is called reduction, because oxidation number mein changes are just because of loss and gain of electron ultimately. So this is the concept and this is the trick you can apply always. So I hope it is very clear that what is redox reaction. Okay, so now let us see the type of redox reactions. So let's take the type of oxidation reaction. The very first type is combination reaction. This combination reaction we have learned in the junior classes, so I'm not going to describe you in detail, but definitely as per the concept of oxidation and reduction, we'll be describing it. For an example, here if I am mixing C plus O2 and I am making CO2. It's a combination example because here two of the substances are combining to form a single substance. So any reaction wherever two or more substances combine to form a single substance, that reaction is known as combination reaction. Now let's see what is happening with the oxidation state. So let's see zero oxidation state of carbon. Now it is not combining with anything else. Zero oxidation state of oxygen, not combining anything else. Here this carbon is connected with the two oxygen, so you can see there two oxygen, this way it will be connected. One bond is pulling one electron, so it is at the minus 2, it is at the minus 2 state. So how many electrons are being pulled from the carbon? Plus 4. So the oxidation state of carbon in this compound is plus 4. So I hope it is clear. So you can see the changes in the oxidation state, plus 4 and minus 2. Now I can find out carbon is changing from 0 to plus 4. So 0 to plus 4 means what? Here there is an oxidation of carbon. So carbon is getting oxidized. This is oxidation reaction. On the other hand side, let us see the oxygen. What is happening with the oxygen? It was there at the zero oxidation state before, no? Now it is at the minus 2. So what is happening with the oxygen? Oxygen is undergoing reduction reaction. So oxygen is getting reduced and carbon is getting oxidized in this reaction. Hence this reaction is a redox reaction. What type of? Because two of the things are combining to form a single substance, it is a combination type of redox reaction. Let's take one more example here, very simple again. Here I am taking magnesium and I am reacting it with nitrogen. Magnesium nitride will be formed and the formula is Mg3N2. And oxidation state, magnesium 0, nitrogen 0. Oxidation state of magnesium in this magnesium nitride, plus 2 and this is at minus 3.
Okay, this is ionic compound, and in ionic compound we can easily assess the oxidation state now. That is, it is made up of Mg plus 2 ion and N3 minus ion magnesium nitride. So it is 2 and it is 3 cross multiplied. The formula is Mg3N2. Okay, so here what is happening with the magnesium? Let's find it out. So magnesium is turning from 0 to plus 2. So there is increase in oxidation state, means it is oxidation. Let's see the nitrogen. What is happening with the nitrogen? It was 0. Now it is minus 3. So there is decrease in oxidation state. So it is reduction. Okay. So this way you can see this. These are oxidation reduction reaction as well. Because the combination is taking place, this is a combination reaction. Now the next type of redox reaction are decomposition reaction. And these decomposition reactions are opposite to combination reactions. So let's see what are decomposition reactions by taking an example. And very good example is sodium hydride I am taking here, which is converting into Na plus H2. So sodium hydride NaH is converting into Na plus H2. And we know that very clear. We know that already that NaH may, Na is always at the plus oxidation state, and obviously the minus oxidation state will be of hydrogen. This happens with the hydrogen only when it is with the first group element or second group element. So this sodium hydride is there, and when it reacts, when it decomposes into sodium and hydrogen, and the oxidation state are 0. So can you see there what type of changes are taking place there? Sodium, which was at plus oxidation first, now it is at 0. The oxidation state is changing from plus to 0. Plus to 0 means reduction. So just reduction. And in this case, hydride is turning from minus to 0. And minus to 0 is the increase in oxidation number. So it is oxidation. Okay, now you can see here there is oxidation and reduction taking place. Same way, if I am taking another decomposition, suppose it is MgCl2 and it is turning into Mg plus chlorine. It is at the plus 2 oxidation state, it is at the minus 1 oxidation state, it is elemental state, it is elemental state. Now what? Because the magnesium is turning from plus to 0, it is decrease in the oxidation state. So decrease in oxidation state is reduction. So magnesium chloride is reducing to magnesium, and chloride, what is happening with the chloride? It is changing from minus 1 to 0, and there is increase in oxidation state, and that is why this is oxidation. Okay, so most of the reactions which are decomposition reactions are redox reaction, but not all. Let's see one more example in where the decomposition reaction is not an example of redox reaction. How we'll find out? The example is CaCO3 on heating decomposes into CaO plus CO2. And in this particular reaction, calcium carbonate mein, calcium ka oxidation state is always plus 2. Oxygen ka oxidation state in oxo anion is minus 2. And the oxidation state, and we have 3 oxygen here, so I am multiplying it with 3. And the oxidation state of carbon we have to find out because we are not confirmed. It changes its oxidation state. So it is X I am taking. So what is the oxidation total? Charge will be 0. So 2 plus X minus 6 equals 0. Oxidation state of carbon is plus 4. So the oxidation state of calcium is plus 2. It is plus 4. And oxygen is minus 2. In this case, calcium is at plus 2, oxygen is minus 2. In this case, carbon is plus 4. How carbon is plus 4? We have already discussed. It is pulling 2 electron, minus 2. It is pulling 2 electron, minus 2. Now, 4 are pulled. That is why plus 4 oxidation state. So, this is the oxidation state of carbon, and minus 2 is the oxidation state of oxygen. So, can you see there what is happening with the calcium? It was earlier also at plus 2. Now also it is at plus 2. Carbon, it was earlier at plus 4 before the reaction. After the reaction, again it is plus 4. Before the reaction, oxygen was at minus 2, but now again it is at the minus 2 oxidation state. So although this reaction is a decomposition, but this is not a redox reaction. So do remember, all the decomposition reactions are not redox reactions. Okay, let us see the next type of reaction, redox reaction, called displacement reaction. Simple one, we have done it many times. So let's do it. So the displacement reactions are those reactions in which more reactive element displaces less reactive element from its compounds. So these we are going to further divide into two parts, there are two types, and that is metal displacement reaction and non-metal displacement. Okay, let's start with the metal displacement. It is very simple one. We have already done it in the 10th class many times, and it is one of the very important reaction we have done in the 10th standard. And we know that the metal, the reactivity of the metal can be assessed by looking at the reactivity series. So you will look at the reactivity series and then you will come to know that the metal which is more reactive, yani the metal which is at the higher side in the reactivity series will displace the metal which is present at the lower side in the reactivity series from its salt solution. If you want to go in detail of this metal displacement reaction, you can watch this video, because here in this video I have explained to you in detail, just like 10th class student. It was for the 10th class, it was in detail. So I am giving you just the reaction because it is a reaction from the 10th standard. I am not going to explain you again. So this is what metal displacement. I am giving you the example. A very common example is zinc. When react with copper sulfate solution. Remember that this copper sulfate solution is the aqueous solution, means we are taking the salt solution and I am reacting it with a more reactive element. Zinc is more reactive because it is placed higher side in the reactivity series. So it is giving you, it is displacing copper from the salt solution and will take its place. So here we will be getting ZnSO4 and copper will remain free. And obviously, because this is happening here, zinc was earlier at the zero oxidation state. Copper in copper sulfate is made up of plus 2 and plus 2 ion. And here sulfate ka we are not changing the oxidation state, because sulfate ion is sulfate on the left and sulfate on the right hand side. So there is no change in the oxidation state of sulfate ion. Here I am taking sulfate ion as sulfate ion. We are not splitting the sulfate ion into sulfur and oxygen, for the sake of simplicity of the reaction. So copper was plus 2 before and now the copper is at 0 oxidation state because copper became free during this reaction. Zinc was 0 before, but now the zinc is at plus 2 because it is linked with the sulfate ion. So you can see there that zinc is getting oxidized because its oxidation number is changing from 0 to plus 2. Jabki copper is getting reduced because its oxidation state is changing to 0. So this reaction is a metal displacement reaction because the metal is displacing another metal in this reaction. But that only metals are not there which are displacing, the higher one is displacing the lower one. Non-metals also undergo the reaction called displacement reaction. That we have not done before, but we are doing it right now. So let's see what are non-metal displacement reactions. Before starting non-metal displacement reaction, I want to give you one instruction related with that so that you will easily understand the displacement reaction of non-metal. And what is that? The fluorine is the most reactive non-metal. And in the group of fluorine, the reactivity of the non-metal changes from fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. That is, the reactivity decreases this way, means the fluorine is most reactive, and in this group, in the group of fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, in this particular group the reactivity decreases when we go up to down. Apart from that, we have two more very electronegative atoms, and these are oxygen and nitrogen. These oxygen and nitrogen are also very non-metallic in nature, and very non-metallic means other than fluorine, these two are very non-metallic. That is, the first position is of fluorine and then the oxygen and nitrogen and then chlorine, bromine and iodine. So fluorine, oxygen and nitrogen, these three non-metals are very reactive non-metals. Okay, now we can understand that these are the most reactive. So these can displace the other elements from their salts. Okay, so let's see some of the reactions in which non-metal is displacing other non-metal. So the very good reaction is, see to this reaction, fluorine, when we react it with the water,
this will form HF and oxygen will be made free. As you can see here, this fluorine, because of being more reactive, I told you this is the most reactive non-metal. So this fluorine is going to displace this oxygen from the water and will take its place. So it will attach itself with the hydrogen and release the oxygen out. So this is what happening here. This fluorine is displacing oxygen from the water and making hydrogen fluoride. So this reaction is displacement reaction of fluorine, where it is displacing oxygen. Another example is, if I react potassium bromide with chlorine, as you can see the position of chlorine is up and bromine is at the downside. Chlorine is more reactive than the bromine. So what will happen? The bromine can be displaced by the chlorine. So we will get KCl and the bromine will remain free. So you can see here that bromine is displaced by chlorine and chlorine has taken its position, making the bromine free. So this is called non-metal displacement reaction. So here we have next type of reaction and last redox reaction, that is disproportionation reaction. Disproportionation reaction are those in which a single element undergo oxidation as well as reduction. Means here the two different elements are not undergoing, one is getting oxidized, another is getting reduced. The single element we are going to take and the single element will be undergoing oxidation as well as reduction. So let's see the example of disproportionation reaction. So here is the example of disproportionation reaction. Let's find out why I am calling this reaction as a disproportionation. Look at this compound. This is H2O2. We can take out the oxidation state of hydrogen and oxygen in this compound. And we know that this compound is hydrogen peroxide. This is what? Hydrogen peroxide. And in hydrogen peroxide, oxidation state of oxygen is -1 peroxide linkage. And hydrogen is always at the +1 oxidation state. Except when it is there with the first group and second group element. So here it is. H2O2 -1 +1 oxidation state. Here this water is at +1 hydrogen and -2 oxygen. We can calculate it also if you want. That is 2 hydrogen +1 oxidation state. Oxygen, suppose we don't know what is the charge, 0. So this becomes 2 plus S equals 0. That is the oxidation state of oxygen becomes -2. So we can calculate it also. Now the next one is oxygen. This oxygen is at the zero oxidation state because this is in the elemental state. Okay. You just concentrate on oxygen. So let's see what is happening with the oxygen. This oxygen is converting into -2, that is O2 minus. It is converting into water also. And here it is converting into oxygen. So in case of water, it is turning from O minus 1 to -2. And in this case, it is turning from -1 to 0. So when it is turning -1 to -2, it is reduction because decrease in oxidation state. And when it is turning -1 to 0, it is oxidation. So you can see here that oxygen of hydrogen peroxide is getting oxidized as well as it is getting reduced. So this type of reaction where a single element, here we are taking oxygen, single element is getting oxidized as well as reduced during the reaction is known as disproportionation reaction. Let's take one more example of this kind. Now in this example, we can see that this chlorine is at the zero oxidation state. I'm concentrating on chlorine because here in, as a two product, we are getting chlorine only. So this is chlorine is at zero oxidation state and here we can calculate the oxidation state of chlorine. Oxygen is at -2 oxidation state. In most of the cases, I am taking it -2. Chlorine, I don't know, so I am taking it X. What is the overall charge of this species? -1. So X becomes +1. So here this oxidation state of chlorine is +1. Here the chlorine is at -1 oxidation state. So can you see there the chlorine is changing its state from 0 to +1 in this case. And it is changing its state from 0 to -1. So 0 to +1 condition is called oxidation. And 0 to -1 is called reduction. So the chlorine, a single element, is turning into oxidized and into the reduced form. I hope all four type of reactions are very clear to you, and you can now understand how to find out whether the reaction is redox reaction or not. So if you like the video, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe it also. Thank you very much.